Let's do some MLB Cover the Bases here. So your favorite plays in the following categories for tonight's Major League Baseball. We're talking main slate here. So first base, which favorite are you backing tonight? Go ahead, Paul.
You know, the Jays are the biggest favorite on the board in tonight's action, and I'm going to answer the question that you posed. They are the favorite that I'm backing because the O's are the punching bag in the American League, and this show is all about the Get It Right League, isn't it, guys? The contending teams in the AL can't lose a series to Baltimore, regardless of whether it's home or away. Tonight's pitching matchup underlines the disparity between the clubs. Alex Manoah is red hot, and Keegan Aiken is not, and that will go a long way toward duplicating what we saw in Camden Yards last night.
Garion, you got to love Paul taking your Bluebirds.
Yeah, it's an all Toronto segment here. But look, if we're looking for value, it's tough to say the Jays or the Mets. They're just such overwhelming favorites. I guess you could parlay them together. I believe that pays out about plus 20 on the DraftKings Sportsbook. So that could be something to look at if you want like the Julian Edlow special. But in terms of this slate as a whole, I don't know if it's good news or bad news. I would say it's fun, good news. This is not a slate to back favorites. This is an underdog-heavy slate. I would say in terms of just a team that's not crazy bet up, the Padres' money line isn't terrible at minus 148, but even then you're betting against Max Scherzer. Yu Darvish has been incredible at home this season. He's got a 2.12 ERA, a 34% strikeout rate. But, yeah, I would say in general I'm more excited to bet the underdogs on this slate than I am to back a favorite.
Okay, so speaking of that, second base, that is the underdog category we're hitting on now. So go ahead, Gary, and who's your dog?
I'm going to go with the Tigers. We talked a lot about the Tigers' offense in the first segment of the show. Let's talk about the Tigers' pitching in this game. Tarek Skubal was a punching bag the first month and a half of the season, but he has been the top 50 MLB prospect you would expect him to be in his past nine starts. He's got a 3.44 ERA that is backed up a 3.31 xFIP. He's got a 33% strikeout rate in that span of time as well. So, yes, the Twins really do hit left-handed pitching very well, but Josh Donaldson is a game-time decision for this contest. He has not played in their last two games, and if he's not in the lineup, this roster suddenly doesn't look so great and so menacing against left-handed pitching. And then you've got Jay Happ, who, you know, as we talked about already, 7.45 ERA since the beginning of June. I just think the Tigers, who are actually 7-3 in their last 10 games, do not deserve to be the underdog, even on the road in this matchup.
Paul, the underdog, you are backing tonight.
The underdog pick of the night for me is the Royals over the Indians, given that the home side is favored at minus 135. This is a battle of teams that haven't been playing very well at all of late. The visitors are only 3-7 in their last 10, but Cleveland's on a 9-game losing streak. The pressure in that case is always greater on the struggling team when they're at home. The starting pitching matchup also favors the visitors. That's just a few of the number of factors that allow me to favor KC tonight as the underdog.
Paul, as we take a trip now to the hot corner, to third base, favorite run line bet on this slate?
I got two of them for you. My favorite run line bets are the Dodgers at plus 100 over Miami and the Jays over the Orioles at minus 148. Dodgers have scored 100 more runs than Miami and will put up big numbers against them again against the Marlins tonight. And the Jays will wash, rinse, and repeat over the Orioles, just like last night's game will be a replay. Consider the difference in their offense and the aforementioned difference in the pitching matchup. It's two big disparities there and too much to avoid.
Care Bear, you're up.
Yeah, I'll back Paul here on the Jays run line. Minus 148 is a much more palatable price than minus 225, which is what it is on the money line. And as Paul can also attest, the Jays either win by 20 or lose by one. So it's not surprising to find out that they have the seventh best run line record in all of baseball. They can score runs, and Keegan Aiken, it's not really his fault. This guy shouldn't be in the majors. The Orioles are forcing him to be because they just need starters. But 23 earned runs his past 17 innings. I don't think he's going to have a lot of fun facing this Blue Jays lineup, so I will take them on the run line.
Give me that game total as we continue to cover the bases. We're heading home, Garion.
I'm going to take the over in Philadelphia-Chicago. I'm a little surprised this is only 7.5 runs and that the over is even money. It is plus 100 right now. There has been no shortage of runs so far in this series. Wrigley has been playing like Wrigley tends to in the middle of summer. And these two starting pitchers, I think, are a little overrated. Adzale had some nice starts to begin the season, but he's really tapered off as of late, and he struggles immensely with left-handed bats, as I talked about earlier. And you've got Zach Eflin, who, same kind of deal, was really nice in April, was pitching okay throughout May, but has started to have some troubles in his last five or six starts. So I'm not expecting this to be like 10-9, but I think a 6-5 game is a lot more likely than a 3-2 game.
Game total, your favorite one tonight, Paul.
I got a couple for you. I go back to the KC-Cleveland game and count on two struggling offenses to continue to flounder and hit the under 9-run total game score. And I also love the pitching matchup. I might stay up and watch this one. The Nats and the Padres, Scherzer versus Darvish. I say these two studs go a long way to limit both offenses and hit the under 7-game score here.